It is now 10:59, and we're back in order.
I have a parliamentary inquiry, Mr. Chairman.
Can you hold on for 1 second? I believe the parliamentarian has a point he'd like to...
I just wanted to mention that... Well, there's some gray area that people who, the purpose of a point of information or point of inquiry is solely to ask a question. If you think you need to make a statement or any sort, then that's not a point of information or point of inquiry. And the purposes of those should really only be to clarify the motion. The only reason it has priority is based on the general principle that people should understand what they're debating or voting on. But it's really only understanding in a very technical sense. Any statement about underlying facts or anything like that is purely debate.
Mr. Stanley, do you have a...
I have a parliamentary inquiry. Actually, I'm going to go over there. It's easier to do. I'm taller. It's easier.
Kevin Stanley. Mr. Chairman, I have a parliamentary inquiry about the correct procedure to follow. Should a member ask a question or obtain a ruling from the chair that he or she disagrees with. Am I correct, Mr. Chairman, that should a member get a ruling from the chair that he or she disagrees with, the correct procedure to follow would be for that person to appeal the ruling of the chair?
That is correct.
And I wish to continue. And should that appeal be sustained, that person would be right. And if that appeal be overturned, the chairman would be right.
In terms of the meeting, yes.
Thank you. thank you for the clarification, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Buff, for what purpose does the member rise?
Warren Buff, I would like to move to suspend the rules and reconsider the motion to reform the YA committee, instead forming it with Aurora Celeste as chair, as we had requested in a motion I believe we submitted.
Is there a second for this?
Second.
Do we need to debate it?
No.
All right.
Celeste in the...
May I make a speech in favor?
Do you need to make a speech in favor?
I need to say a sentence.
I need to understand what's happening.
Okay.
This gets 4 minutes.
All right. I'm asking for a new committee chair because I would like to see the committee move at a reasonable pace rather than submitting at deadline so that the members of this body have time to consider our suggestions and research.
Mr. Cronengold, for what purpose does the member rise?
Joshua Cronengold, would the membership of the committee remain the same?
I believe that the motion is to keep it the same except change the chair. And I have no intention of changing the membership. All right, we're going to vote on this. It takes a 2/3 vote to suspend the rules. All those in favor, please raise your hands. Hands down, all those opposed. All right, the ayes appear to have it, the ayes do have it, the committee is reconstituted.
Thank you.
All right, now we get to EPH. It is on page six of your agendas.
Debate time is
20
minutes.
Debate time is
10 minutes. 20. There is currently on the screen is a URL pointing to where the analysis of... Can't see it. Okay.
Jared, I have 20 minutes of debate time.
I have 20.
Okay, it is 20 minutes. I have it wrong.
You gave me one job.
All right. Mr. Quinn, as the maker of the motion, would you like to make a speech in favor?
Jameson Quinn. Actually, before I make a speech in favor, current Hugo and Minister Dave McCarty has asked me to make a motion. I have forwarded the text of this. I have sent you the text of this motion to your email. to the email of the chair. I'm wondering if that could be put up on the screen. It's a technical fix to make the administration easier. And the difference, I don't have the text in my head, but the idea is that if anyone is withdrawn, you just go down the list of people eliminated in reverse order. You know, the last person to be eliminated, the last work to be eliminated would move up, rather than rerunning the process, and it's just to make things easier for the administrators.
Strike tax.
Hold on.
No, I haven't gotten the email yet.
I haven't gotten it yet.
Did he send it to business meeting?
No, he sent it just to me.
Oh, okay.
I don't actually have text. I just have...
Oh.
It amends 384.
So would you like me to...
It's 384.
Get...
Yeah, so we would... Yeah, strike out the first sentence of 3A4. Actually, we would just... Yeah, just strike out all of 3A4.
No, it's not just strike that out, because you have to rewrite it slightly. Here it is.
Where was 3A4? Okay. I think you just eliminate the word rerun and it fixes it.
All right, so the maker's motion is, before we get a second, so we can know what we're seconding, to amend section 3A4 to read, on page 7, to read, after the initial award ballot is generated, if any finalists are removed for any reason, they will be replaced by other works in reverse order of elimination. That would mean that the sixth place person would go up and so. Dr. Adams, for what purpose does the member rise?
Hang on, I need to get this. I need
a
2-second break.
Andrew Adams, parliamentary inquiry. Does the chair rule that this would be a lesser change?
Yes, it's closer to our
current. Yeah, because it goes back to current Hugo practice, so that's a lesser change.
The existing list.
You wish to appeal the ruling of the chair?
All right, well, I need a minute here, so give me a timeout.
From on page 7 in 384, strike from the finalist selection process shall be rerun down to the end of 3A4 and replaced by.
They will be replaced by other works in reverse order of elimination. That means the one that was eliminated just before you got 5 goes on next. And then the one just after that, and so on and so forth. Once the secretary is caught up, I will make my opening statement on the appeal of the ruling of the chair. Does everybody remember how we handle appeals of the rulings of the chair?
Yes.
There was no second.
Mr. Goldstein, for what purpose does the member rise?
This is mainly for the movers of the motion. Could you please give an example as to whether or not this actually makes a substantive change in the process?
That's out of order at this time. We're in the middle of an appeal of the chair.
Right. The reason why I think it might be in order is this would in fact inform us whether or not the chair's ruling is valid or not.
And it's a debate on the ruling of the chair.
Okay.
Jared, it's 2-2, right? To appeal the ruling.
It's, 2 minutes in favor and 2 minutes against.
All right, so here's how this works. I get to make a speech against. There's 4 minutes of debate. Everybody can speak once within that 4 minutes. I get to speak at the end. And then the question is put, shall the ruling of the chair be sustained? That means a vote in favor is a vote in favor. A vote in favor is sustaining the ruling of the chair. That means you agree with me. A vote against means you disagree with me. So Mr. Blogg, for what purpose does the member rise?
Gary Blogg, before we start the debate on the ruling of the chair, can the amendment that Jameson is proposing be read slowly once again?
Yes, I will read it one more time. Okay.
Okay, 3.A.4. After the initial award ballot is generated, if any finalists are removed for any reason, they will be replaced by other works in reverse order of elimination.
Maybe I can type it. All right. Yes. Please come to the microphone.
My name is Edmund Schweppe, and I just like to know, could we have a repeat of what exactly the ruling of the chair is that we are appealing to or from or against?
I'd love to if I could ever get there. I really am trying to not have us be in here all day, just saying. The ruling of the chair is that this amendment constitutes a lesser change. That means that it is a change that the people who first passed this motion would have definitely agreed to.
No.
It's closer to common practice.
Yes. Trust me, I have this job for a reason. The reason and that would mean that it does not need to then go forward again for ratification, that we could ratify it this year. The reason I am arguing that it is a lesser change is that the people who voted on this last year voted to change the system by which we administer the Hugos, and I believe they would have changed it less if it had been proposed. This change brings the new system closer in line with the current system. That means that the process by which we would run the nominations under EPH is more like what we have currently. And it is my sense that the people last year would have agreed to that change. Now I'm looking for someone to speak against the Ms. Faber. Mr. Yallow as the, yes, I apologize, Ms. Faber. He does get.
The reason I do not believe this to be a lesser change is that I believe the rerunning is an orthogonal process to our existing eliminate and replace. It provides something entirely different, and therefore one cannot say that a particular thing is greater or lesser or closer or further, because in fact it is so different that making those kinds of comparisons is impossible.
Point of information.
Yes, Ms. Faber.
I'm sorry, I was confused by your explanation because you talked about the people who voted on this last year, but I thought we didn't vote on this last year. I thought this was the first year we are voting.
No, EPH is up for ratification.
My bad, I'm sorry.
I'm looking for a speech in favor of the chair's ruling. Ms. Rudolph.
You have 30 seconds.
My name is Anne Marie Rudolph. I think effectively what Jared is saying, at least to me, is that there is less process involved in this and there will be less impact. The first run that gives a ranking of works will be used to replace any works that are knocked off of it, rather than taking that work out of the original run and redoing the whole thing, which could slightly change all of the results. So in that sense, I feel it's a lesser change.
Speech against the chair's ruling. Mr. Breitbart.
Mr. Quinn. Jameson.
Seth Breitbart. As someone who voted for this last year and participated in the discussion, this point was raised, and the idea was that rerunning it was a fairer method for all concerned than not rerunning it.
For what purpose does the member rise?
The chair has said that if it would have been agreed to by the previous year, my question is, does that mean, would they agree to the change as opposed to the full EPH amendment as passed yet last year, or would they agree to the change as opposed to the status quo as existed before then?
They would agree to the change as opposed to rerunning EPH. Those who voted for EPH would have definitively agreed to, while including the rest of EPH, not include rerunning it.
Yeah. But if the original EPH had had the text as amended, you are saying they would have passed that just as they did pass
yes.
EPH. That is my question. Thank you. And so the what Mr. Breitbart's
please sit down. Mr. Kowalczyk, for what purpose does the member rise?
Isn't it true the only issue is whether or not it's a lesser change, and it's a lesser change to the Constitution, therefore how people voted last year is irrelevant?
Yes. Mr. Korngold, for what purposes? I'd really like to just make...
Yes, how much time remains for debate?
None.
Virtually none. I'd really like to just make my closing arguments. I think that this brings the motion for EPH closer in line with current practice, and that it would have, that it is a lesser change. I'm not going to spend too much time debating this. All those in favor of sustaining the chair's ruling, please raise your hands. Hands down. All those opposed? All right, I'm going to say the ayes have it. The ayes do have it. The ruling is sustained. This can be ratified this year.
No. We haven't actually adopted the change.
I said this.
Call a question.
Yeah, I understand. I was speaking to the deputy.
Yeah.
There's a motion to call the question. Is there a second?
Second.
Is there any objection?
Objection.
Who still wishes to speak on the amendment?
I have priority because I've
made. No,
do you want to speak?
To just raise your hand if you want to speak on Mr. Quinn's amendment.
He does.
Okay. It requires a 2/3 vote to close debate. All those in favor of closing debate on just the amendment, raise your hand. Hands down. All those opposed? All right. The ayes appear to have it. The ayes do have it. We're going to vote on Mr. Quinn's amendment. That is to reword section 3.A.4. All those in favor of the amendment, please raise your hands. All right, hands down. All those opposed, I'm going to say the ayes have it. The ayes do have it. The motion is amended. Mr. Stanley, for what purpose does the member rise?
Kevin Stanley. Mr. Chairman, I move the foreshadowed amendment on the board to require annual re-ratification of this proposal through 2022.
Do we need to debate this?
No.
There are people asking to debate.
Actually, Mr. Chairman, I will not give a speech in favor unless somebody wants to speak against it. All right, very well, then I reserve my time on this. Mr. Chairman, as with the similar clause that has been added to three-stage voting, I believe that due to the relatively changing nature of what we're going through right now, we really need the ability to move a little bit faster than we have. I am generally in favor of requiring 2 years on all changes. This is one where I think we are better off giving ourselves the flexibility for the next several years to say, let's get out of this now. Thank you.
Mr. Wallace.
I must say that while I am, David Wallace, yes. While I am in agreement with the general sympathy or the general feelings behind this amendment that we want to be able to move more quickly, I believe it is the wrong approach to take, and I have a substitute amendment to offer as soon, assuming that this one is rejected, and I will urge you to reject it and vote on my amendment instead. I have also submitted that. Basically, my approach will be, rather than allowing a vote to not ratify...
I'm displaying it right now, your alternative.
My alternative. Yes, my alternative is to simply say that any business meeting between now and the ultimate re-ratification of EPH can vote to suspend the effects of EPH for 1 year. The reason for this is that if we vote not to re-ratify at some intermediate stage, and then we discover that we actually needed EPH, as may be evident in the results of the following year, then it would take 2 years to bring it back. If instead we use this approach of allowing the business meeting to suspend it if they think it is not needed, then if the results of the next year make it clear that yes, it was needed after all, they can bring it back just by not voting to suspend it for the next year. So I would urge you to vote against the original amendment, and then I will immediately put forward this substitute amendment. And that's just for a technical reason that I believe that it was not in order to move this as a substitute motion. So.
Ms. Secor, for what purpose does the member rise? Ms. Secor, can you come to the microphone?
Hang on, I need a timeout. I need a timeout. Just a second. Where does it come from?
Ms. Secor, go ahead.
Mr. Chairman, I'm Kate Secor. Point of parliamentary inquiry, with these re-ratify every year things, if in one of the intervening years we amend the thing, does that trigger a re-ratification of 2 years?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
I'm sorry. But point of elementary inquiry or whatever. The
text that is up there is not what I actually submitted. I did not submit the strikeouts. It was an addition to, not replacing.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
That we'll get to that when we get to your... Mr. Walling, for what purpose does the member rise?
Point of information.
Please hold on.
Should this not be an amendment by substitution?
We're working on Mr. Stanley's amendment, which I don't believe is an amendment by substitution. We're not handling Mr. Wallace's amendment right now because as Mr. Stanley's amendment is not an amendment by substitution, it is not in order to make a second order amendment. So if we get through Mr. Stanley's amendment, then we can get to Mr. Wallace's amendment, and then other things. Mr. Is there a second to calling the question? Is there any objection?
Wait. I need to know what Kevin Stanley's motion is.
The one he submitted in writing beforehand.
Oh. Okay, so we're still on the...
I'm very sorry for the interruption. Quick note from the Sergeant at Arms. Please silence all of your electronic devices. We're hearing a lot up here.
Can you come to the microphone?
This is...
Why don't I have Kevin's amendment that was... Which one?
I remain in Barmouthson. Mr. Chairman, would this constitute a lesser change?
Yes, because it requires re-ratification.
It may cause the thing to be in effect for less time.
Right. Yes. All right. Is there any objection to calling the question? I didn't actually hear it. Okay, not hearing none, we're going to vote on Mr. Stanley's amendment. All those in favor?
Stated.
It's to require re-ratification every meeting until...
It requires re-ratification every meeting until 2022?
22,
yes.
Yep.
Yes. All those in favor of the amendment, please raise your hands. All right, hands down. All those opposed? I'm going to say the noes have it.
Division.
How many members wish to have a division?
Lots. Enough.
I'm going to say that's...
It's actually
10%. Exercise. All right, I think we have to do it. As we have before, we're going to start on my right side of the room. We're going to go front to back, then through the center, front to back, then through my left, front to back. All those in favor of the amendment, stand up now. If you can't stand, please use your voting card.
We're here very short.
One, two, three.
I would ask people not to talk.
Five, six, seven,
All right, we're going to start at the front.
31 32 33 34 41 42 43 44 45 46 47 48 49 50 51 52 54 63 64 65 66 67 68 69 63 64 65 66
going to start at the front, and I know the videography is that.
67.
No, 68.
79 79 80 81 82 83 84 85 86 87 88 89 90 91 92 93 94 95 96.
Is there anyone on
96?
97. What? Or explain information, I don't know. At what point would it be in order to state that I heard two people say 54?
It would be in order now.
I heard somebody over there say 54, and I heard Michael Lee say 54. I heard that number twice. If those people disagree with me, I freely admit to being wrong.
I didn't hear it.
Yeah, right. Thank you.
It's one.
What were you?
My count was 96.
Yes,
yep.
That's correct.
96. All right. All those opposed to the amendment, please rise. Same process.
36 37 38 39 40 41 42 43 44 45 46
Yeah, he's 95, you're 96.
Haven't counted us.
98?
99.
It's, I believe the count is 99 to 96, which means the noes have it. The noes do have it. The amendment fails. Mr. Wallace.
Anything to make these things shorter.
So I now move to add this foreshadowed amendment as a proviso clause to the motion that provided any business meeting prior to 2022 may move to suspend the changes introduced by E. Pluribus Hugo for the following year's Hugo nominations only. Yes.
Please come to the microphone.
Cliff Dunn, did Mr. Wallace intend to include the two previously rejected clauses, seeing as those were not struck out in his proposal, or did he just intend to include this single clause as a sole standalone?
It's an addition. The language, the ratification language for requiring a re-ratification in 2022 should stand. Yeah, that was part of the motion last year, and my intent is that it remains.
I'm going to recognize the man in front first over here. Please come to the microphone.
Don Tim, T-I-M-M. Point of parliamentary inquiry.
Yeah, take it out of the...
Yes, thank you.
Parliamentary inquiry. In view of the fact that it talks about suspending the rules, would that require a two-thirds vote for passage, or would that be a majority vote?
I don't believe it mentions a suspension of the rules, but I can't actually see the screen for it.
Suspend the changes introduced. No,
that's not a suspension of the rules. That is to suspend the changes implemented by EPH. That is not a suspension of the rules.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Sir, can you just give your name to the secretary?
Don Tim.
The man in the back. Yes, you, that turns around.
Don Tim, thank you.
So, point of parliamentary inquiry.
John Dawson. Mr. Chairman, in the opinion of the chair, is this Mr. Wallace's amendment as constituted a lesser change, and therefore this would not require re-ratification?
How did I know that question was coming?
Sure, it's lesser change.
Yeah, it keeps the changes in for less time, so I'm going to say it's a lesser change. Mr. Quinn. There hasn't actually been a speech against yet. Is there anyone wishing to speak against?
I haven't given a speech in favor either.
Yeah, actually, that's true. You got interrupted. Can you yield just so he can... He just read the motion.
Right.
Go ahead.
Okay. So, as the maker, as I said, I understand the motivations behind the movers of the previous amendment. We're in a time of flux when the Hugos are under attack, and it's not entirely clear how many different pieces are going to be needed to be able to get to where we want to get to, and it's not always clear how those things are going to interact. I understand the desire to say that maybe there's a better change coming along that when ratified, we wouldn't need EPH, or maybe people will decide at some point that there's something that doesn't interact well with EPH, they may feel they need to make a choice between them. This allows them to do so simply by a resolution of the appropriate business meeting, but it allows us to bring EPH back immediately if it becomes clear that EPH is needed. In general, I think my personal feeling is we want to get as many things in the pipeline as possible, because I think it's going to take a bunch of different changes to address different pieces of the problem. And just in case anybody thinks, as we were maybe hoping last year, that the puppies were going to go away after paying for one round of nominations, I note that from the Hugo data last night, that there were 170 people who voted for Vox Day over no award that are members of this year's convention. They will undoubtedly be nominating next year. So clearly this is an ongoing problem. We need to have the maximum flexibility to deal with it. I believe this amendment allows that flexibility in terms of crafting the correct solution as we go forward. Thank you.
You are now recognized for a speech against.
Janice Galekas, and you'll probably want to see that.
G-A-L-E-C-K-S. Wait,
don't
let 15 seconds left.
Janice Galekas, my concern with this particular amendment is that it's always going to be one too late if we decide next year that we don't want it because we look at the numbers and turn it off, and then next year we say, oh, we should have had it, let's turn it on. It's always going to be one behind the issue that we're trying to deal with.
Mr. Kroningold, for what purpose does the member rise?
Parliamentary inquiry. Is the appropriate way to call the question to gain the recognition of the chair and then call the question, or to simply shout it out from the audience?
Technically gain the recognition of the chair and then shout it out.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I call the question.
Is there a second? Is there any objection to calling the question? Seeing none, we're going to vote on this amendment. All those in favor, please raise your... What?
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 Parliamentary inquiry. What? Can you read the amendment again?
No.
It's on the screen over here.
It's on the screen. Move over here.
He can't see it.
He can't see it.
All right, I'll read it again. Provided that any business meeting prior to 2022 may move to suspend the changes introduced by E Pluribus Ugo for the following year's Hugo nominations only.
Thank you. All right, all those in favor of the amendment, please raise your hands. Hands down, all those opposed. I'm going to say the ayes have it, the ayes do have it, the amendment passes. Now, on the underlying motion of EPH. Miss Bemis, for
I move to call the question.
Is there a second?
Second.
Is there any objection to calling the question?
Objection.
All those members still wishing to speak, please raise your hands or stand up. Do the hokey pokey. I don't. All right. The motion to call the question and end debate requires a two-thirds vote. All those in favor of ending debate and calling the question, please raise your hands. All right, hands down, all those opposed. I'm gonna say the ayes have it. The ayes do have it. The question is called. The question is now on EPH as amended.
Point of information?
Yes.
I don't think all of us have seen the new data yet, the report that was handed out. I certainly haven't seen it.
Yes, that is a point of privilege. There are copies. Would the meeting allow a suspension of the rules for a two-minute interlude before the question for Mr. McCarty to present the information?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Mr. McCarty, you have the floor.
The URL to the information is also on the slide.
Yes. Actually, pull it up. It's not on there, but we can't get
it. It's too much to do on slides. We'd have to go through quickly. The paper is going to be the best way to do it. So I know.
Okay.
So I want to say, so I didn't finish preparing this report until 6 in the morning, and I left out vital information to make it understandable to you guys, so I want to apologize for that. As you're looking at the paper, you are looking at, for each category, on the left, here is the long list as constituted by our current rules. On the right, here is the long list as constituted by EPH. It should be a landscape.
There are only 5 copies, unfortunately. We understand that this is a
series. More than 5. There was some passing.
Okay.
They got some more.
Mr. Kowalczyk, for what purpose does the member rise?
Point of information. Can you state that there are actually 2 different things, 5 copies of one,
yes.
And 1 copies of the other?
Yes. So there are extremely limited copies of Mr. McCarty's report. Mr. McCarty's report is 51 pages long. That is why there are limited copies of the report, because it didn't get finished till 6 o'clock in the morning and it's 51 pages and that takes time to print. There are multiple copies of the long list from last night's awards. That is probably what most members have. Does everybody understand the difference between the two?
Yes.
Jerry, okay. Can we get this front?
We're working on getting it on the screen.
There's a summary page for each one, and if we could show those, it's probably
we're
useful
working
enough.
On getting it up on the screen as best we can.
We've got it.
The page before that page.
Dr. Adams, did you have?
Okay. All right. So I'm going to go over here so I can see it, because I can't do this from memory.
Yes.
All right. So in yeah.
The,
it's a PDF, I'm sorry. All right, so in the ballot that was in the long list that were released last night, had we run EPH against it, what that's showing is for novel and novella, there would have been no change to the ballot, and under novel, something that had made the long list would have been knocked off. Novelette, one thing would have been changed, short story 2 and related work 2, graphic story 3, all told there were 9 ballots out of the 17 in our ceremony that would have been affected by EPH with some number of entries in the top 5 being adjusted. On average, EPH will change somewhere just more than 1 per category where slating is present. And it, however, also will change things in the long list where no slating is really present. It does make changes that are kind of unintentional to things, but they do have an effect.
Will the speaker yield for a question?
I think I must yield for a question.
Jerry Lohr. I believe I'm looking at page 3. I believe I'm looking at page 3 of the thing that you're looking at the summary page for here. And I would ask you to explain the right-hand column on,
okay.
on the
page?
Best novella.
What's the header of the page you're looking at?
Page 3 would be novelette. One more page.
Novella. Okay.
No, sorry, novella.
It's on the screen.
So novella is unchanged. Right. It's the same.
And I'm looking at
you're looking at the points column?
Is it sorted correctly?
It is sorted correctly. Okay, you're wondering how something with more points ended up on the ballot than something without points.
That's the question.
Absolutely. That's one of the things that is non-intuitive, perhaps, if you don't actually run EPH. So when, I believe the last selection for the last position was the builders against the prince and the pauper prince, etc. So the fact that those two had the lowest number of points made them the choice to see what was going to move on. The selection of what moves on is which has more nominations, and the builder at 489 has more than the lower one at 307, so it moves on to the final ballot. That is how EPH works.
Mr.
Yes.
Mr. Block, do you have a question for the speaker?
Yes, I do.
Mr. McCarty, I'm sorry. On page one, I didn't see the dramatic presentations.
Okay, so that's that was addressed in the previous report that's on the website. The dramatic, Jameson and I collectively feel that looking at the dramatic presentation categories is misleading because the categories are so narrow. We as a body natively slated before puppies started doing anything anyway. So there's more movement there for that has nothing to do with the behavior that we're trying to see. So we felt it best to exclude those categories when trying to determine what EPH does.
Point of personal privilege. Yep. I don't fully agree with that. I do agree with that for BDB short.
Fair enough, but yes.
Mr. Olson, for what purpose does the
ask a parliamentary inquiry. I'm finding this extremely useful. I don't know how much more there is to say, and I don't know how much Jameson wants to say, but is there a way we can let them answer questions jointly and get through this data before we vote without opening debate to all kinds of shit?
I believe the meeting agreed to suspend for 2 minutes. Would it agree to suspend for 10 minutes to allow Mr. Quinn and Mr. McCarty to answer questions as a team? All right, so we're going to have 10 more minutes of question time. Does that work? That's what we're doing. 10 more minutes of the question time. The man in the orange.
I have a laser pointer if you want.
So one thing.
Is this a suspension of the rules?
Yes.
Can you just show related work? I think people probably want to see that one.
I can't read a thing on the screen. My name is Mike Lowry. Simple question, would the application of EPH have eliminated any of the winners from the ballot?
This year, no. However, in our testing of prior year's data for the London Hugos in 2014, EPH would have eliminated a Hugo winner had we been using it at that point.
Which one, may I ask?
For the life of me, I can't remember. It was a case of there being a tie in and six things on the ballot wherever that occurred.
So it was tied for fifth.
It was tied for fifth, and EPH knocked it off.
EPH broke the tie.
For all practical purposes, there will be no ties in EPH. It is mathematically very unlikely for it to ever happen. I don't know if we adopt it. I don't know that we'll see a tie again.
Ms. Foster, are you rising for a question, or just so you can see the screen? Okay, just so I knew. I saw the man on the end rise for.
Here's a question for Dave. First of all, in preface, that obviously a lot of us still feel. I'm Richard Lynch. Rich Lynch, excuse me. There's a lot of us who feel that this is so opaque and it makes not a whole lot of difference that basically, in carny speak, it could be equivalent to snake oil. Maybe perhaps that's a bad way of describing it, but nevertheless.
Either get to the question or.
My question to Dave.
Yes.
We trust you implicitly because you know what you're doing. If it was up to you, do you recommend that we do this or not?
That's still debate. That is not a question on the.
I will be glad to answer that when we get to debate, if we get to debate.
Yeah, we actually have already cut off debate and then suspended the rules just to add this. Go ahead.
Mr. McCarty.
Yes.
You haven't included the dramatic presentation results. Is it not true that EPH will still be applied to the dramatic presentation categories?
Yes, but as noted, when Jameson and I were doing the comparisons, we felt it inappropriate because the answers are not as germane as on all the other categories, we feel.
If they make changes, they're germane, aren't they?
What? That's debate. I'm going to, however, let Jameson answer that question as well.
So, Dave.
You can call me anything. I had to take no offense.
Okay, sorry. What he said is he feels it's not germane. The reason I believe it's not appropriate to put BDP short up there is that it is just a data nightmare. It's really much harder and would have been, I mean, Dave has done a lot of work. He obviously did a great job last night. He's obviously running on not the amount of sleep that one would like. And And so I just wouldn't want to ask him to do that level of work. BDP short is literally as much work as all the other categories put together.
Sir, Ms. Polk.
Is it appropriate to ask how much work, in your opinion, this will place on future management of the Hugos?
I'm going to say that's debate.
Okay, thank you.
That's fine. It's a cut and dry thing.
Yeah, but it's not about.
No, it's an informational question.
This affects the Hugo administrators.
Yeah, but it's not about the application of the data. I'm going to rule it's debate.
In the chair's opinion, would committee of the whole be a good thing at this point?
Yeah. So move it if you wish.
The speaker asked if moving to create a committee of the whole rather than just a question time on the application of the data was in order, or was what I wanted. I'd really like not to, because I really do understand.
I think some of these questions affect.
I can't stop someone from doing that.
I really, really, really hate to extend this thing, but people are asking good questions.
Just go ahead and make the motion.
I so move.
Is it second? Is there any objection to just devolving into a committee of the whole for how much time do we have left?
5 minutes.
For the next 5 minutes, so that. That means that.
So for half time. I'm sorry, I don't understand what difference that would make.
So right now we are in question time on the application of EPH to the six, five, however many data sets we have. That is the only questions that are germane. If we devolve into a committee of the whole, we can debate without actually debating the motion, which means
that I don't have to take minutes.
Right. A, the secretary doesn't have to take minutes. B, Ms. Polk can ask her question, and other questions that would have been ruled debate would be answerable. Does everybody understand the difference?
Yes.
I heard one no, but I'm not going to deal with it because there's an overwhelming understanding. All right, is there any objection to devolving into a committee of the whole? There's an objection there. That means we have to vote on this. All those in favor of devolving into a committee of the whole? All right, hands down. All those opposed? Hands down. The ayes appear to have it. We now have five questions. I'll let Mr. McCarty answer Ms. Polk's question now.
So Ms. Polk's question, if I...
What?
You need to stop recording.
Yes. No, Mr. Chairman, my point of order is not that we were not allowed to go into committee of the whole because the vote involved was clearly enough to take the two-thirds vote to suspend the rules and go into committee of the whole. Mr. Chairman, I do not believe that you are allowed to preside at this point.
Oh, goody. I'm going to appoint Mr. Illingworth. Also, we need to actually agree to recording or not recording.
Recording.
All right. It seems the sense of the meeting. So, Mr. Illingworth, it's all yours.
Oh. All right. So,
right.
Going back to Ms. Polk's question, I'm going to restate it so she can confirm that I understand it correctly. The question is, how much effort do I think is involved on the administration team to do this? Is that roughly true? I think it's if you have blind faith in computer systems, it's not hard. If you want to check anything, it takes more time than the administrators have. And that's not to check everything, that's to check anything. It took me a couple months of going back through and looking at numbers until my eyes bled to make the initial report. This report is not checked nearly as much because I could not look at the data in time to get anything ready for this meeting. So I had to trust that everything was done correctly. That makes me uncomfortable as an administrator.
Primary query.
Who? We're committee of the whole. Just get the floor.
Parliamentary inquiry. Is my previous question in order at this point?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, Dave, we entrust you implicitly.
That's a mistake. However,
Do you think this is a good idea?
I have said publicly that I don't think this is a good idea. I think it's opaque. I think it can't be explained to people who are affected by it. The only way to check the date, the only way to check that the administrators have done their job correctly is to get access to the raw data, which is never released to anyone except for this testing. I don't think it's a good idea. However, I don't want to say that my concerns are the only concerns. And so I have tried my best to be very helpful to Mr. Jameson and to do this because this is an interesting goddamn voting system. It really is. And I've tried not to let my personal feelings affect that, and I hope that they haven't.
Mr. Olson.
I have not really closely compared this year's results with previous year's results. In the opinion of Jameson and Dave, in the opinion of Dave Jameson and Dave, are the previous year's results and what you have up this year basically the same, or were there significant differences?
There was a difference, but I don't think it was necessarily. Your significance depends on you. I believe that EPH was slightly more effective this year than last year, and I say that as an administrator, feeling that the slating behavior was actually stronger last year than this year. It did more this year against, to my mind, weaker slating. And it's not innately predictable as to when it's going to be strongly effective and when it's not.
Jameson, do you want to?
Essentially agree, yeah.
Another question?
We have some over here. They've been up for a while.
Yes, I know they've been up for a while. That's why I'm ignoring them. I will not take anyone who is standing to gain recognition during the previous question. You.
May I actually make a statement?
Sure.
Yes? Yes, please do.
You probably have to do it in the form of a question.
I'm Nathaniel on the road. I'm Nathaniel Narode. You've now seen two of the categories. I'd ask that the fan cast category be put up as well. I haven't had a chance to look at it either.
What order is that?
That's just past fanzine, so near the bottom.
I've actually studied voting
up,
theory.
One more. Here, fan cast. There.
I've actually studied voting theory as a hobbyist for over 25 years. It's a very old mathematical subject. It moves extremely slowly. The system which the Hugos currently use to select their the finalists has a couple of names in voting theory. One of them is block voting, which is because it is extremely susceptible to slates. There is a lot of literature on how to make a system in which a slate cannot dominate a list, where when you're trying to generate a list, it's called the representative committee problem in the literature. You're trying to generate a list, you don't want a small fraction to be able to fill the entire list. Systems which have the characteristic that they don't allow the fraction to fill the entire list are called proportional systems or semi-proportional systems. The current system you have is not proportional. That's why they sometimes call it block voting. EPH is a proportional system. Is it the best proportional system? I don't know, but as a proportional system, no slate is going to fill the ballot.
Okay. Can I treat that as a question and make a statement
Certainly.
Related to it?
Yeah.
Okay. Absolutely, I agree that EPH is a proportional system. However, the end result of the proportional system is, on average, our small perverse minority of 10 to 15, possibly 20%, but more likely 10 to 15, is still going to control, on average, 80% of the ballot. So we're putting a lot in for a little benefit, and I think that there are other ways to address it.
I would like to dispute that and say that it means they will control 20 to 50%, as you can see in the fan cast from the difference in results.
Rachel, Miss Axe.
I remain Rachel Axe. Just a question for you, Dave.
Sure.
With how difficult is it going to be to explain the way the system is run to potential voters, and what do you feel that that's going to do to the faith of the voters in the system? Thank you.
All right. I am not a public relations person, so I don't think that I can necessarily answer that except to say that I find it to be a little difficult. And I don't think I can answer more than that. Sure.
Mr.
I'll just note that in the information session that we had following whichever Thursday or Friday's meeting, I was able to boil the essence of the system down to one slide. So it's obviously a little more complicated than what we have, but the key parts of the system can be explained in a very few number of lines.
Rick Kowalczyk, please.
I have a computer science degree. I disagree with that assessment. We seem to be glossing over a dramatic presentation. Dave McCarty, what do you think this would do to dramatic presentation?
I think dramatic presentation would be most consistently the thing that's changed most often. Long list and short list, both.
I actually disagree with that.
Ari?
I don't. So please, feel free to think that I'm lying to you on that one, because I don't have data to show you, and I'm willing to, for you to think me a liar.
Ari Goldstein, so I understand that you actually went through the old data sets and looked for errors or problems. Did you find any? And if so, how significant were they when run through the computer simulation?
Okay, so EPH relies heavily on canonicalization. For EPH to work correctly, everything that's germane to the question has to be 100% canonicalized. We have to figure out everybody. Effectively, we only run it against the top 20 finalists in any category. Everything below that is noise and isn't going to affect the results. But for those top 20, we have to find every variation of an answer that should be included. Whereas, because the difference of plus one vote or plus or minus one vote can materially affect what's eliminated. Under our current system, the plus one vote or minus one vote, generally speaking, does not even change their position on the long list most frequently. So administration teams generally leave that to go. So it was a lot of cleanup to do this. Now, that said, the administration teams do that during the course of nominations. So that specific thing, I don't think, is a legitimate reason to say we can't do it, because the workload is more, but not impossible, and that doesn't happen at crunch time. That happens when you have leisure over the months of people voting.
Okay, we're out of time at this point on the committee. Where's Jared got to?
He got to pee if we didn't.
He's coming.
Jerry Sullivan, is it in order to move to extend this for 3 minutes?
It's in order, but...
So moved.
Second. Let me sit down.
The committee has expired, and now I have to... For what purpose does the member...
It's a point of information, but it might be parliamentary procedure. I have an answer to a question one of the makers posted earlier.
That's not in order right now. The motion on the floor is to extend the committee of the whole for an additional 3 minutes. It's been seconded. Is there any objection? Yes. All right, all those in favor of extending by 3 minutes, please raise your hands. Hands down, all those opposed. Nice. I'm going to say the noes have it. Therefore, because when we suspended the rules to devolve into a committee of the whole, we were at the question. We are now back at the question. Mr. Buff, for what purpose does the member rise?
Sure. Move to take a 5-minute recess.
Exactly. Can we vote first and then call the recess?
I'm actually deliberately asking to call a recess before the vote. So that we can discuss the data we've seen and look at things.
Is there a second move? Is there objection to recessing?
Objection.
All right, we're going to vote on... I know, we're going to vote on whether we recess for 5 minutes. All those in favor of recessing for 5 minutes, raise your hands. Yes, simple majority. All right, hands down. All those opposed, please raise your hands. I'm going to say the noes have it. The noes do have it. Now we're going to vote on the underlying motion of EPH. This is for ratification. All those in favor of ratifying EPH, please raise your hands. All right, hands down. All those opposed, I'm going to say the ayes have it. The ayes do have it. The motion is ratified. And it's pretty clear. No, we're not going to do it. Now we're going to stand in recess for 5 minutes because I know people need a break.